Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Really quick before we get into the video, a lot of you guys have noticed this fancy poster here that I've hung up in my house, and several of you have told us you want it in the real world. So, we did it. I've just opened up keeponthinking.co, where you can pick up this poster and also all kinds of other cool stuff that we're really proud of, like these shirts and these comfy socks. Click the first link in the description to check it out. We couldn't make Life Noggin without you, and 100% of what we sell will go right back into making more videos for you. Thank you from the bottom of my pixelated heart. Now let's get back to the video. While my animator can delete me with just a few keystrokes, hey, watch it, buddy. Sorry. It can be quite a bit more complex to bring an end to the human world as you know it. At the risk of being super morbid, let's take a look at just how the last scenes in our movie about humanity might play out. I just hope there's a sequel. Or at least an after-credits scene. You know, for Earth 2. We know the effects of global warming and climate change are scary, and are going to affect our future. But global climate change has already affected the world in many observable ways, from loss of sea ice, to the accelerated rise of the sea level, to shifting plant and animal ranges. But if global warming doesn't bring an end to the world, then what might it cause the world to look like for future generations down the road? Future human youngsters might have to deal with the long-term effects of global climate change, like increasing temperatures, greater occurrences of heat waves and droughts, stronger and more intense hurricanes, and the Arctic Ocean becoming free of ice. In fact, the sea level is supposed to rise 1 to 4 feet by 2100, further increasing flooding in many parts of the world. Maybe we should let the future humans know they should try and learn how to live underwater, or at least get some cool snorkel gear. Going even further, life for the next generations might be riddled with other complications of climate change, like famine and social or political instability. But life in the future might not be all that bad. One thing humanity always seems to be good at, and I'm a little biased here, is creating wonderful new technologies. A type of technology that future generations might have as a part of their lives are brain implants that could allow people to connect to the internet. Even the modern marvel Elon Musk is on board with his recent launch of the company Neuralink. This startup company aims to create what Musk calls neural lace, which would be technology that's built into the brain that could create a wireless interface between human noggins and computers. I know that kinda sounds like a scary sci-fi movie, but that's still pretty cool. There also still seems to be a push for flying cars to be a part of our future. While there may be some safety and practicality issues, a study from the University of Michigan found that 2/3 of Americans want to ride in or operate their own airborne vehicle. Uber seems to want to capitalize on that desire with Uber Elevate, which hopes to one day have a force of VTOL aircrafts, or vertical takeoff and landing vehicles, for urban transportation. You humans sure do love the idea of flying. I don't mean to brag, but I can teleport, so I don't need flying. Oh no, I have no idea where I am, I need to get out of here. So what potential future technology interests you the most? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, my name is Blacko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.